Historically, when our country calls in a time of need, we, the military, answer that call.
Pride say there is no other way. I tilled the sorrows of stone.
Many of us have returned with physical and mental evidence that freedom isn't free, and we have paid that price.
Hi, I'm Kate Yeager. This is a story about American Lake Veterans Golf Course and about a group of local volunteers on a mission. But more importantly, it's about how we say thank you to America's veterans who have sacrificed so much. Meet Vietnam veteran Russ Carlson.
Everybody I run into, I says, you know something, we got one of the best volunteer golf courses you'll ever find. And then they say, volunteer, and I say, yeah, volunteers. And they say, no such animal. I say, you want to bet, come out and take a look. If you want to help out, hey, do so, you know. Because like I say, we're all volunteer, we don't get paid. And every dime that we get goes into this golf course. We don't take nothing out for ourselves, nothing.
Steve Reynolds, 2 tours in Vietnam.
Bob Kinkala, 14 years in the Air National Guard.
Bob Davis, United States Navy.
People ask me, well, why do I work out here? And I say, well, it's like I give back to veterans. And they say, well, so you can go play golf. I says, no.
I come up here and I just see a lot of people that need an outlet, something to make them whole again.
Associated with and bordering both Fort Lewis and the VA Puget Sound, American Lake Veterans Golf Course has become a haven for American heroes returning from war, many of whom were injured.
Good shot.
But it hasn't always been this way. In 1995, Congress cut all government funding from military golf courses. Many courses vanished. American Lake was in bad shape. But in 2001, one man, Pepper Roberts, on his first day of retirement from teaching, stepped foot on these grounds and began his life's next chapter.
The only people that could play the course was those that could walk.
By 2004, Pepper changed American Lake to a nonprofit, welcoming monetary and construction donations from regional organizations and businesses. It resulted in the course's underground irrigation system, a covered driving range and picnic area, and best of all, a course redesigned so physically challenged veterans could finally play via solo riders.
All you have to do is come out here on a day that the wounded warriors are out here.
You can't stand up, stand out.
To see the joy in their faces, it's extremely heartwarming.
I'm a diehard skier, I'm a diehard hand cyclist, but man, I'll tell you, nothing is more exciting than being able to hit that ball and follow it down there and stay in that fairway and get to the green.
Oh, perfect.
The ultimate goal of rehabilitation is getting patients back into a healthy outlet for living, and this golf course provides all of that.
This is such a big stress reliever for many of those soldiers. They're able to do some maintenance around here, play a couple rounds, talk to other people who love a sport that they love.
In the fall of 2009, it was announced that the nine-hole American Lake Veterans Golf Course would construct a back nine. So, American Lake volunteer and former PGA Tour and Ryder Cup member Ken Still shot for the moon.
Somebody said, we need to get Jack Nicklaus involved. I called him. I said, Jack, I need to get you involved in American Lake Veterans Golf Course.
I'm there. Just count me in.
Spontaneous answer. I said, Jack, what are you going to charge? He says, well, Ken, there'll be no charge. I said, Jack, come on.
For what these guys have given to us and sacrifice their life and limbs for us. No. There would never be anything for that.
Back in Lakewood, Washington, the news spread fast.
Jack Nicklaus, man.
When I heard that Jack Nicklaus was going to donate the design to this American Lake Golf Course, man, I can't imagine. What a wonderful thing for a man to do.
Built on Veterans Administration property in 1955, American Lake's 2,800 yards aren't short on beauty. Still, to know what makes this course unforgettable, you can't just look. You have to listen to voices of veterans, like Jim Martinson. who served in Vietnam.
Somebody stepped on a bouncing Betty landmine. It came out of the ground. It blew up about waist high, and it killed three of my friends, wounded 12, and I lost my leg and finger at that time.
But Jim can play golf here.
Oh, yeah.
At first, you're going to tell yourself you're going to walk again, and you're going to be able to do all the things you did before, and you're in a lot of denial.
3 years ago, an IED in Iraq blew up Danny Dudek's vehicle. He can no longer use his legs. But Danny can play golf here.
We were landed on Omaha Beach, 7th day of June, 1944.
On D-Day, Red Burton was a 26-year-old ammunition chief. Now, he's 92 years old. Doesn't get around quite like he used to. But Red can play golf here.
Woohoo!
These men can all play here because American Lake is the only golf course in the country designed for use by disabled veterans.
It's a vehicle for getting all the veterans out here to play, no matter what their handicap. That was my goal when I started doing this, was to make it a place for all veterans to play.
77-year-old retired Navy man Pepper Roberts keeps the course running and accessible for the veterans who need its recreation so much.
It's not just because Red's 92 or if Jim doesn't have any legs. Every group out here is like a small support group. We have young kids that come back that have been wounded pretty seriously, and for a lot of them, they think it's over. And then they come out and they find out it isn't.
Elmer Stevens was a medic in Vietnam, laid low by post-traumatic stress disorder.
I tried to commit suicide 3 times, and if it wasn't for my friends in this course, I wouldn't be here right now. I'd be 6 feet under.
But Elmer can play golf here.
Once I come in the gate out here, all my problems just disappear, because I know I'm going to my second home, because I feel secure here. And I got a lot of friends that I golf with that are the same way.
Enough disabled vets have come to rely on this course that it was time to provide more opportunities to play here. So Tacoma native and former PGA Tour player Ken Still turned to his teammate on the 1969 Ryder Cup team.
Kenny Still called me and he said, "Jack," he said, "I need some help." I said, "What do you need, Kenny?" He says, "I'm involved," he says, "down here in this American Lake Veteran Golf Course, and it's all for disabled veterans coming back from overseas. And they've got a little 9-hole golf course here, and it needs more golf."
We go through there, and we play down to where that tee was. So that becomes a par 5 down there.
So Jack Nicklaus volunteered his services and began designing a back 9 to make American Lake an 18-hole course. Once that's done, he'll spruce up the front 9.
It is a timeless tale. Young men go off to war and some never return. And for those who do come home, there is often a bitter price to pay, one that can last a lifetime.
Well, I served in during the Korean War. I went in 1950, got out in 54, and then I got involved out here, when I turned 70, that's when I retired, so that's 7 years ago.
Very good. Felt good?
All right. I think you'll find that most of them feel very strongly about the course, probably because of what it does for them. For a lot of these veterans, this is just about their whole entertainment, their whole life. They come out here, they volunteer, they come out and they play, they come out and spend time with friends when they don't play.
This place is incredible. The things that they did for those of us on Met Hold and what they do with the veterans, and it's something that it's a great outlet for stress. It's a great place to come out and just, I mean, you can come out here, relax.
We're going to start out with going down through the driving range. The driving range is really one of our bigger projects, part of what we call the total wear practice area. It doesn't matter if I can walk or if I have to hobble or use a cane or if I can't walk at all, because we have solo riders. you can come out and play golf. You can come out and be here. So now we have a driving range that's covered. We have three holes for the handicap to play on around the perimeter of the driving range. We have a nice chipping green and a sand trap. And we have a new putting green that we put in out here.
Pepper Roberts and the other volunteers here believe these goals can be achieved, and they base that confidence on what they've already accomplished. Russ Carlson has friends in high places like retired Army General John Shelikashvili, who considers American Lake Golf Course a wonderful island.
Of people who are convinced and are trying to prove that they will not let their handicaps destroy their lives.
Shelikashvili served as chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff from 1993 to 1997. Born in Poland to Georgian refugee parents, General Shelikashvili is the only immigrant to reach the rank of four-star general in the U.S. Army.
Right about there.
A stroke several years ago left him paralyzed on one side. Once an avid tennis player, Shelikashvili now works with Pepper Roberts on his new game, golf. He grades himself?
Mediocre.
But the general sees the bigger picture and just how important American Lake is.
If you really love soldiers, airmen, marines, sailors, then there's no better way to prove that than to help support this effort.
In fact, Shelikashvili is such a believer, he's now co-chair of the Friends of American Lake.
Because I've seen the results, you gotta show them that there is life after your injury.
His son tells us coming here has helped the general's outlook, his recovery, and just maybe his golf game.
That's it. That's it. All right. Good job. Our next project is to actually build a whole new nine holes for the course, make it into a full 18 holes. The amount of play that we had a year ago last July compared to what it is was this July, we had about 12 times as many rounds of golf played as we had a year ago. That's putting a lot of stress on our little nine-hole course.
It's absolutely just something that is very, very special in the world today. And to be part of that and to have been asked to give some of our time to help that was an honor for us. So I know that all of you who are watching this message, I hope you feel the same way we do about our veterans and our people that have defended our country. The American Lakes Veteran Golf Course is one that is a pretty special one in the United States, and let's keep it going and get it going. Thank you.
There are many patron sponsorship opportunities. You can sponsor a hole, you can sponsor a tee, or you can sponsor a green. But no matter how you help, consider it an investment.
This whole operation is really an investment in the lives of not only the veterans that are here serving it now, but in the future.
And Pepper Roberts says, with the increasing casualty toll in Afghanistan, the challenge is not going away.
We need people to step up now to invest in the future for these kids. You know, we're going to need this in the future for all of them. And this is a time for them to step up and make that big commitment. And that's what it is. It's a commitment, an investment in these kids' lives.
In 1995, the U.S. government cut off all funding to golf courses like American Lake. Since then, it's been up to volunteers like Pepper Roberts to help wounded soldiers live their lives to the fullest. Over the years, they've gotten financial help through grants and donations, but there's still so much left to do. And aren't American veterans worth it? Pepper and his friends have done their part. Now it's your turn. Won't you help?
Phase 3 will pay for those 9 brand new Jack Nicklaus design holes, complete improvements to the original course and facilities, and provide funding for staff and operational costs. American Lake is at a critical stage now. They need your help. Now, raising that much money is a big mission, but these veterans, whether they fought in Europe or the South Pacific or Korea or Vietnam or Afghanistan or Iraq, these veterans gave the last full measure of themselves for their country. When they were called, they answered. Now, it's your turn.